you for being here, because that means you're stepping up to take on a new task that's really important. Management of the State Department, I think Chairman Corker said it right when he said we've got some morale issues there right now, from what I understand. And it's also important that you've been a former chief of staff to a majority leader and to a whip. And I got to work with you when you were director of the budget committee. As a staff director, you did a good job and were effective in not just your command of the budget numbers, but also managing a team that focused on the chairman's priorities at the time. So I've seen you in operation. You know us. This committee is incredibly important in the process of the management side, as we've seen with the authorization bill. We got through the committee with the chairman's help. So that relationship you have with this place, understanding how we operate, I think is very important on the management issues and beyond. I got two questions for you. One is with regard to security. I noticed in your testimony you talked about your interest in protecting, I think you said, staff and facilities. And, you know, sadly, we live in a world of increasing danger to our Foreign Service staff and those in country, nationals and Americans. In recent testimony, Secretary Tillerson has noted the potential budget impact on the embassy security issues beyond 2018. So my question to you is very simple. How do you intend to work with the Secretary and others to ensure that the Bureau of Diplomatic Security remains properly resourced in ensuring the protection of U.S. personnel, as you talked about, in facilities, in the context of budget cuts to the State Department's budget that have been proposed?
Senator, thank you very much for that question. What I expect, if I have the privilege of being confirmed and working with the Assistant Secretary for Diplomatic Security, is to every day be reviewing our security posture and the support that we provide for security across all fronts at all our posts around the world, including seeking in conversations with Congress inside the executive branch with the OMB and others, that there be an appropriate amount of resources dedicated to security and then expended properly for security on behalf of our personnel. Security and safety will be one of my constant responsibilities that I will expend significant time focused on and advocating for appropriate resources in order to ensure that our Foreign Service officers and our personnel deployed around the world are in facilities that are safe, are able to safely execute their duties, and have security for themselves and as appropriate for their families and loved ones is something that's going to be a critical calling that I'll work to follow through on if I have the opportunity.
I think that's important, and I was glad to hear you talk about it in your testimony. And, you know, again, the morale question came up earlier, and I think that's one of the things that people are concerned about is even their physical security, and knowing that you're behind them I think will be very important. You and I talked a lot about the Global Engagement Center when we met in the context of this nomination, and I told you my concern about the State Department not seeking the funding to be able to effectively push back against authoritarian regimes around the world who are using disinformation and propaganda more, meddling here in our own country, but also in fledgling democracies around the world. And you gave me your commitment in those meetings that you wanted to focus on that issue as well. And I noted that Secretary Tillerson did ask for the funding from the Department of Defense recently that we had authorized here in this body, and I was really pleased to see that. And I appreciate Deputy Secretary Sullivan reaching out to me in the last few days, in fact, about this issue and ensuring that, you know, they have a commitment to getting the GEC stood up properly, both with regard to counter-narrative on terrorism, ISIS, but also with regard to pushing back on disinformation. Can you make a commitment today to us that you will indeed continue that focus of making sure that the Global Engagement Center works effectively to push back and provide adequate resources for that?
Senator, absolutely. To your point, we did have a good conversation on this. I believe the mission of the Global Engagement Center is critically important to advocating the United States' point of view against both non-state and state actor propaganda and agitation against our way of life and the values that we represent. So no question that if I have the privilege to be confirmed, be working to seek to, in any way that my portfolio interacts or supports the Global Engagement Center, ensuring that we are robustly acting through the Global Engagement Center, as well as across a wide variety of platforms throughout the government on behalf of the expressions of our values and pointing out some of the challenges that these other values being advocated for truly present to the world.
Well, thank you. My time has expired. I know it's very important to this committee. Senator Murphy and I did have this legislation that's now in law, and we want to be sure it's properly implemented. Every day there's a headline about some other aspect of this disinformation, so we appreciate your focus on that. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
Thank you, Senator.